that Guido, Kelly Bulls.
I'm Dom Perignon, I don't need Chris. Tangeray and Alize, I don't need shit. Nigga, I'm high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I stay high all the time, I'm on some bullshit. Give me some drove, purple waves, and some chocolate. Give me a Dutch and a lighter, I spark shit. And stay high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I'm high all the time, and I'm on some bullshit. Every time I roll up, niggas holla roll up. Then I tell them, hold up, you ain't getting money, you ain't smoking in my Benzo. 20-inch Lorenzo, smoke in the window. High as a motherfucker, I be on the back streets. Niggas know I clap heat, homie, if you got beef, man, you better holla at me. Niggas get locked up, stabbed up, shot up. Every time I pop up, a lot going on in my hood. I shoot the dice and holla, get them girls. Daddy need new shoes, daddy need Pirellis to look mean on 22s. Stash box, Xbox, laptop, fax machine, phone. Bulletproof this bitch and I'm gone. 2003 Suburban swerving, too many sips of Henny. The D's sick, they search the whip and they can't find the semis. They was just harassing me cause they know who I was. Spent the night in Central Brooklyn smoking some bugs.
Dom Perignon, I don't need Chris. Tangeray and Alize, I don't need shit. Nigga, I'm high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I stay high all the time, I'm on some bullshit. Give me some drove, purple haze and some chocolate. Give me a Dutch and a lighter, I spark shit. And stay high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I'm high all the time, and I'm on some bullshit.
Now if you heard I done started some shit, it ain't because I be high, I be high, I be high. And if you heard I done let off a clip, it ain't because I be high, I be high. But I twist that la 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 la. I get high as I want a nigga. Go against me for show, years a goner nigga. I don't smoke to calm my nerves, but I got beef. Finna crush my enemies like I crushed the ass sheets. If you love me, tell me you love me. Don't stab me, man. I hate to be in the pants clapping one of my fans. Now let me show you how to greet me when you meet me, when you see me. If you're real, my nigga, you know how to holler, G, you man. There's no competition, it's just me. 50 Cent, motherfucker, I'm hot on these streets. If David could go against Goliath with a stone, I could go at Nas and Jigga, both for the throne.
I don't need Dom Perignon, I don't need Chris. Tangeray and Alize, I don't need shit. Nigga, I'm high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I stay high all the time, I'm on some bullshit. Give me some drove, purple waves and some chocolate. Give me a Dutch and a lighter, I spark shit. And stay high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I'm high all the time, I'm on some bullshit.
Now who you know besides me who write lines and squeeze nines and have hoes in the hood sniffing on white lines? You don't want me to be your kid's role model. I teach them how to bump them 380s and load up them hollows. Have shorty fresh off the stoop, ready to shoot. Big blunt in his mouth, deuce deuce in his boot. Sit in the crib sipping Guinness, watching Menace, then oh lord. Have a young nigga bucking shit like he old dog. My team, they depend on me when it's crunch time. I eat a nigga food in broad day like it's lunchtime. You feeling brave, nigga? Go ahead, get gully. See if I'm gonna leave your brains leaking up out your scully. I done made myself hot, so ain't shit you can tell me. Now niggas calling me the feature, man, fuck your money. I ain't hurting, I'm alright, nigga, I'm doing good. I ain't got the right rhymes, I got bricks in the hood.
I don't need Dom Perignon, I don't need Chris. Tangeray and Alize, I don't need shit. Nigga, I'm high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I stay high all the time, I'm on some bullshit. Give me some drove, purple waves and some chocolate. Give me a Dutch and a lighter, I spark shit. And stay high all the time, I smoke that good shit. I'm high all the time, and I'm on some bullshit.
G-Unit, are you ready? G-Unit, are you ready? G-Unit, are you ready? Nigga, ready or not? Here I come, come, come.
This program is intended for an adult audience and deals with mature humor and contains material including language, violence, and nudity that may be offensive to some viewers. Viewer discretion is strongly advised.
Dropping syllables on the digital like slow data. I'm original, making paper. Tell them hey to see you later and catch the vapor. Like, where will I go from here? Still too early to tell, but you can bet I'm prepared for anything. And that's no lie. Spotlight's on you, so you know it's showtime.
Here we go. Good morning, good evening, good night, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's your nighttime, right time, DJ, DJ Music, and welcome to another episode of the Chop Shop. G-U-Nick, you know it. When you hear me come out with something hard like that, I'm going to talk some shit about somebody. Let me turn down my background here just a little bit more. All right, so I'm just going off the rip, let you know, Green Gorilla, BGS, Angry Man, you three motherfuckers got in my crawl. So let me get you out of my crawl. I was going to do this particular stream live, folks, but you know, nah, same point. No need to. Won't be distracted. Won't have to read what folks say down in the chat room. I can say what I say with you folks, to you folks, about the Green Gorilla. This weekend, perusing through the YouTube streets, and you know how the recommendation comes in for you. I saw something that says short bus. And I'm wondering, why do people do that? Why do people associate stupidity with an affliction? Because anytime you got Green Gorilla and BGS on the same panel, it's going to be something about stupidity. And that was absolutely right. So when I saw it, I clicked on it. I didn't say anything. I only had one question. Define short bus. Took him about 12, 13, 14 minutes or so to answer. And I was going to wait to see. I was going to give him 15 minutes to see if they was going to answer my question that I typed in the chat room. Took him about 15 minutes. So while they were in there, while I was in there waiting for them, I just decided to break out the old trusty recorder and show y'all folks what these loose niggas be in there talking about, okay? Now these two folks says, one of them says he has a PhD, and the other one calls himself the master teacher. Well, go over there and get in that sit your ass down chair, because I'm about to school you two dumbasses. Just because you broke book smart, that don't mean you smart, okay? That don't mean that you're not being insensitive, and I'm going to point it out to you, because you never know who is watching your stream. And I took that title to your live stream offensive. I don't know how many other people might have found it offensive. Why would you always assume that someone that with an affliction, whether it be Down syndrome, whether it be autism, whether it be mental retardation or something, some kind of affliction, why would you automatically assume that person to be non-productive? Why would you make a joke, oh, they ride on the short bus with helmets? Like, that's something funny. I hear that all the time in the YouTube streets, and predominantly for black men. I heard you folks attack Raw B's child. I heard y'all attack Jay Prince's child. I've heard y'all attack Bomb Cherry's grandson. I've heard y'all chat, what's the young lady's name, whatchamacallit, it's another. Y'all don't mind talking about other people's children. Y'all don't mind us trying to put together, I'm talking to you, Green Gorilla and BGS, you two niggas don't mind making it seem like black women are slow. You two motherfuckers call yourself educated. Let me stop, because I could go on, but we're just going to get straight to what these two loose niggas said, folks. Without further ado, let's get straight to it.
You got two kids already.
Yeah.
And you're demanding a motherfucker making, like, the top 10% of men, not just black men, but men in the country in general, you're demanding that you have this. Yeah. What's wrong with the dude that you had? The dude who's making 50, 60 G's. What's wrong with the dude?
It's because they think they're worth more.
And that's the problem. That therein lies the disconnect. Mm-hmm. You know, these women are wanting lifestyle and they want material, you know, possessions that so-called put them in a different kind of status level. But that doesn't necessarily mean that you're going to be happy. You know, like, that's not, like, all of this shit you see on TV, man, is just a bunch of shit that they're trying to sell you to sell products, man. Well, that's it.
You see a 300-pound woman take a snapshot with a supermodel dude and think that's the way life is. That's what they see. But it's a snapshot. That's her friend, not her boo. Okay? But she can present it her way. Oh, if she can get him, I can get him. Not true.
Check this out. It says, less than a week into the marriage, she found another female purse in his car.
Yeah.
We warned her about what was going to happen.
She did.
Now, if you folks don't know who they're talking about, there's some lady that chronicalizes some kind of, I think it's called, Who Did I Marry? Or Why Did I Marry? Or some shit like that. You know, it's all the rave. Everybody's talking about it right now in the YouTube streets. To me, it was enough red flags out for you young lady to hit the streets a long time ago. But, you know, stupid is, stupid does. That's all I can say about that. Ain't my business. But it seems to me, as you saw, this is what two motherfuckers with PhDs sat around all damn afternoon or morning on a Sunday or a Saturday, instead of, as they say, educating the little black boys. These two grown-ass men, I know BGS well into his 60s, talking about women they won't have any access to anyway, just based on BGS's age. Why in the fuck are you talking about a 24, 25 year old girl unless she is your niece or your daughter or someone in your family? You don't have access to them women anymore, brother. Who the fuck told you that you should be critiquing women in their 30s? Matter of fact, women in their 40s. Because I guarantee you, the last time you saw a decent piece of pussy is when it had you. And you know what I mean. Green Gorilla, I'm not going to say where I met you at, but the conversation that I had with you, well, had with y'all in that particular meeting that we had, told me that you were not the kind of guy that I would spend my time with. And I even told the moderator of the chat that we were going to hold, that no, I don't think I couldn't work with you just based on some of the things that I heard you say. Nope, couldn't do it. Bubblegum shit, BGS, the master teacher. Y'all heard what they're talking about. If you don't believe me, listen. This goes on not only for the time that I recorded them, but this went on for hours.
Yeah, she knew. She got digmatized.
And she thought her resources could actually pay him like a woman to be faithful. Doesn't work that way with me.
Man, shout out to Hurricane Greg, man. Shout out to Hurricane, man. Appreciate that. Says taco stand twice. Shout out to that brother, man. Thank you, sir.
And then the Lou is called barbecue, right?
Yeah, man. Or the Rice House tax.
Rice House. Okay.
The Rice House is a better term for like what we call the Chinaman.
Okay? Oh, okay.
So it's just a cleaned up term. So a rice.
Now, Green Gorilla, let me ask you, if somebody was to call a black restaurant a nigger joint, you'd be offended, wouldn't you? If some Asian person came over there and flagged your channel for hate speech, all they had to do was clip that one spot right there where you said that an Asian restaurant is a rice house. Or worse, then you tried to clean it up by saying a cleaner word for Chinaman. How about Asian restaurant? Neither one of those words that you used was seeing Asian people or putting Asian people in a favorable way. That is what you call being a racist, or being, or showing your prejudice, I should say, because they'll argue the point that black folks can't be racist. So let's go to prejudice, a preconceived notion. But y'all two niggas, master teacher and PhDs, huh? Okay.
This house is a place where they sell pork fried, chicken fried, special fried rice.
Okay. Chinese food. Huh?
Yeah, man. And they make it in St. Louis in ways that they don't make it in other parts of the country, man.
All right. All right.
Like, yeah, we're like well known for the rice. You know, it's like in California, you don't have Chinese, like Chinamans on every fucking corner. No. You got like maybe like a taco stand, some Mexican food, some barbecue, some, you know, hamburger stands here and there. And like, you know, here is Chinaman. Chinaman barbecue liquor store. That's St. Louis. Don't tell me I'm lying. I'm waiting for anybody to tell me I'm lying. Liquor store, okay. Liquor store, gas station.
What about it, folks? You folks that live in St. Louis. Is what he's saying true? Is it just liquor stores and gas stations and Chinese joints? Well, if it's that bad, Green Gorilla, why the fuck don't you move? Why don't you buy a store and replace those liquor stores with a black-owned business instead of sitting up in a YouTube stream hour and hour, hour after hour with BGS talking about what you don't have, but you're steady talking about, we love that rice. You don't mind spending your money at the rice house, as you call it. You don't mind talking about somebody else's business because you have none of your own.
Barbecue,
okay.
Rice house, and the beauty shop, the nail salon shit. So, he said he keep hearing this from people from St. Louis. Yeah, it is what it is. It's the truth, man. So, let's look at the last couple of clips, man. I'm gonna let BGS get out of here and get with his fam. So, hold on, let me see here.
I'm good for another half hour, so we good.
Okay, so Let's get to this.
He was home with the baby for 15 hours. She come home just to put on her and brush her wig to go to the club.
But you don't see her.
Where's the accountability?
So you mean to tell me that she just had a baby and decided that she want to go to the club tomorrow, or you thought that her having a baby was down in a thing? Because that's what it sounds like. The problem that a lot of people in relationships have is that they want a relationship and they try to fit a freaking square in a hexagon triangle. Like, they don't, it's like, oh, we like each other, we have a connection, but it's more than that. Oh, I love her. It's more than that. Like, relationships are work. He thought he put a baby in her to make her sit down. Mm-hmm. Guess what? She said, I'm gonna stand up.
This would have been so easy if all of us would have just said, she shouldn't have did that. She's crazy. She has a problem. All the other stuff y'all were saying, you don't know it, but you was defending her. And that's the problem in this situation.
And what's the problem? Is she wrong, Green Gorilla? I imagine that's you on the screen there. I'm not exactly sure. Let me see. Is that you?
Oh, we like each other. We have a connection, but it's more than that.
Hold on, let me see.
It's more than that. Like, relationships are work.
Let me see. Is that you on the screen?
He put a baby in her to make her
Green
sit
Gorilla?
Down. Mm-hmm. Guess what? She said, I'm going to stand up.
This would have been so easy if all of us would just say it.
Is that you right there, Green Gorilla? You said this would have been so easy if what? If we all did what?
She shouldn't have did that. She's crazy. She has a problem. All the other stuff y'all were saying, you don't know it, but you was defending.
Okay, defending her and what? Did she say something wrong? You and BGS gonna say just a few minutes, just exactly what this young lady meant. Y'all think because a woman has a baby, that means that she should not go out and live her life. All the rest of her life should be just focused on the baby and you, the house. Because that's how it was back in the old days. See for yourself. And this is a PhD, folks. This is a guy who says he has a PhD. In what? This is a guy who calls himself the master teacher. Teaching at what? Listen to these two fools.
And that's the problem in this situation.
Yeah, they're not trained for this anymore. That's the problem. In the olden days, she'd be trained to sit down as she had a baby before she got here.
This nigga said, in the olden days, she would sit down because she was trained. Of course, back in the olden days, BGS, master teacher, women didn't have autonomy like that. A woman didn't have rights back in the old days. A husband could tell her, his wife, to do anything. And if she didn't, do you know, BGS, and I hate to refer this to you because I don't know if you go check it out, but I know some, maybe in the last 10, 15 years, there was a book, there was some law, I was a law on the books in Beaufort, South Carolina, that at 12 o'clock, high noon on Sunday, a man could take his wife to the courthouse steps and beat on her to 12:01 if she didn't adhere to what he said throughout the week. So you think, BGS, that that would go over well today? There's also a law on the book still in Columbia, South Carolina, that says it's illegal to park your horse on the right side of the street on Saturday afternoons. You think that law would still be in effect, BGS? You think that some archaic laws that are still on the books that just haven't been removed are still and should still be enforced? The old days, what old days are you referring to? The old days of maybe your great-grandmother and your grandmother? Because that show wasn't going on in the 60s, in the 70s, in the 80s. So what old days did you talk about that a woman had to sit down that you can think of? She had to sit down after having a baby.
It'd be that they're partners instead of wives. So they act like partners.
Man, these chicks, man, get like postpartum depression. Here's the thing. First of all, they, how you gonna go through a whole phase after you have a baby, man?
Now, that's a PhD right there. Referring postpartum depression that we all know some women go through. It's a legitimate thing that happens to women after having children. So much so, it's a concern that some women get so depressed, postpartum depression, that some folks think that they will harm their child. So that is real. So what does her sexual activity have to do with that? Are you trying to say that the only way to cure postpartum depression, this dude, this green gorilla with a PhD, is to get fucked? She got to return back to her hoe face? Well, let me ask you, who impregnated the hoe? Dude? Who impregnated said hoe? Who married said hoe? You didn't know before you married it? Didn't you hear the old adage? You can't turn a hoe into a housewife? Oh, don't worry. We're going to get to why I'm here. The short bus comment. Don't think I forgot. I just got a little distracted with this bullshit y'all two niggas is talking about.
He never got out of her hoe game.
It's like, how you gonna be on some hoe shit after you? Like, this is sexy red culture, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she was a hoe before she got pregnant. Hoes get pregnant, man.
Yeah, this is true. Yeah.
She didn't just start being that way. You saw that her having a baby with it, but that's gonna stop her from having, stop her from actually being a hoe. She's still a hoe. She was old when you met her. She's still hot. Come on, man.
Hey, man. Hey, look. All I can say is, man, I've seen some strange shit. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to say nothing right now, but I'll probably talk to you about this offline. You know what I mean? But anyway, shout.
You know why you don't want to talk about it offline? Because you know somebody would probably clip that shit and call you out on that bullshit, Green Gorilla. Again, who is impregnating these hoes, BGS? Who is the loose nigga that's going out picking up these hoes and raw dicking them? Guys like you. Because you don't hear me talk like that. You don't hear me talking about she always been a hoe. Yeah, hoes get pregnant. It's guys like you that thrive in that hoe culture. It's called supply and demand. As long as there's a demand for hoes, there's gonna be some women that supply. And usually the demand overwhelms the supply. That's why a lot of you niggas is sitting up in these YouTube streams complain about the hoes that you can't get.
Shout out to Mr. Heat, man. I gotta give him them honors, man, for that, you know, generous donation. You know what I'm saying? Anytime I see one of them, I gotta give it up.
Having a baby does not change people. Where people get that from?
Yeah, I think this is true. But I think though it can change some people. You know, especially if they feel like this baby is tying them down to a specific kind of lifestyle. I've seen it happen to where women panic from having children. You know what I'm saying? They kind of like get caught up in like I can't deal with
and
these.
Men, and men don't panic from having children. Men don't run. Men don't say, I don't think I can handle this. Is that what you're trying to tell me, Green Gorilla? For every single mother out there, there is a single father. So who's right and wrong in that situation? It's individual. It's an individual thing of why you and your baby mama ain't together. That's not a universal thing. Are you trying to tell me, Green Gorilla, man with a PhD, that there are no white single mamas? That the only problem that exists with single mamas is in black neighborhoods? That is our culture, BGS, Master Teacher. Are you guys for real?
Right. Bitch, you should have thought about that before you opened your legs up and fucking had a baby. But you've been opening your legs up, but now this baby kind of...
Yeah, nigga, you should have thought about that before you went up in her raw dog. 50-50 chance. Because you know you niggas ain't got no pull-out game. 2-3 minutes, poof, you done. Only thing you can say after that is, oh, damn. If you dealing with that type of woman, who is to blame for that? You, not the woman. Are you trying to tell me, BGS, Green Gorilla, and for all you folks down there that's agreeing with what he's saying, that there are no quality women, that all women are trifling hoes? So much so that y'all feel comfortable doing a live stream about this and then getting on the phone like two cackling hens later on and talking about the very same subject, but on a more personal level. Bitches do that, not men.
I'll tell you what it does to some women. It makes them feel like they're going to miss out on something.
Yeah.
You know, like they can't, like they're tethered to this shit now and, you know, They feel like they're going to miss out. They call it FOMO, fear of missing out.
Yeah, yeah.
But you know, hey, man, the grass ain't always...
Fear of missing out on what? Are you saying, again, men don't do the same thing? They don't feel that having a baby ties them down, especially if they're not married to the woman? They don't feel that maybe financially they can't support a family? That's been going on since whenever. And BGS, to be a man of your age, I cannot believe that you would sit down and spout this rhetoric out of your mouth. But y'all supposed to be teaching young men a life lessons. Fellas, if this is the life lesson you want, you don't want much. I'm sure in your neighborhood you can find the local hoe house. If you are in Charleston, South Carolina, if you head toward the naval base, it used to be called Sproul Avenue. Now I think it's called Metropolitan. They got them in all price ranges, walking up and down the street. They so bold now, they don't go out. They only come out at night. They come out in the daytime too. You can have all you want, as long as your money right. But blame it on the hoes.
Green on the other side. You better ask some motherfucking body.
And this women are not trained to handle that when it comes up. Okay. They're not wise, okay? They're really not mothers. They're not trained to be mothers. They're like baby carriers. So when they get panicked and then they have to take care of this kid and they've been trained to take care of a kid, they panic. No, this ain't for me.
It's a baby carrier.
Yeah, the baby carrier.
Damn. Baby carrier.
They're not
I never heard that term. Gestators.
Now, what if Cynthia G was sitting on our platform and called black men sperm donors? That's all y'all are, just sperm donors. That's all you're good for, sperm donors. We don't need you after that. That's basically what BGS just said. Women, y'all are just baby carriers. Who they carrying the baby for, BGS? But these are supposed to be educated men that you hear talking right now. These are men that say they are pillars in their communities. These are the men that you hear speaking right now, BGS and Green Gorilla, that say they are educated, highly versed, highly active in their community, black men. What fucking community are you in? Oh, you got to be kidding me. You got to be kidding me. Wait a minute. Let me find something. Hold on. Yeah, that'll be good. That's a good one right there. Yeah, you got to be kidding me. Even the white dude looking crazy at you. What the fuck? Let's continue.
You know, basically, the wounds. The walking wounds. You what they are.
Oh, walking wounds. That's what he said. They are, women are walking wounds.
It's crazy, man. He's just a rare form with the shit today, man. God.
So that woman did not change just because she had a baby that was already in her. And the guy thought he was actually going to change her by having a baby. It didn't. Because you went out the next day, right after having the baby, out to the club. I can't wait to drop this baby as you go to the club. I've heard that before.
So I get some new dick in my, so I can get to the same situation, I'm gonna get pregnant again.
Man, there's chicks out there that are 8 months pregnant out in the club dancing. Big old belly out the club dancing.
I just seen a clip from Sexy Red where she throwing her ass back after getting her hair done in the motherfucking hospital in scrubs.
Yeah.
I'm like, man, this shit is crazy.
We think babyhood's gonna change it. Okay? Just like women have their babies work out. He's not gonna become a upstanding husband just because he has a baby for him. It's not gonna work that way. It doesn't work that way. They same guy. guy that you had the baby for, before you had a baby. Same guy. Oh, you supposed to be a husband and be a father, stay at home with the kids and not turn up and hit the streets? No, it don't work that way.
Yeah,
it doesn't work that way at all.
This is the shit. Hold on, wait. That's the show.
I know you got one more. Go ahead.
Hold on. No, let me see. Share screen. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Now let me stop that right there. Now see, do I agree with what Sexy Red is doing? No, I don't. But is there something wrong with a pregnant female dancing? Absolutely not. Do I think that Sexy Red should be up on stage with a child in her stomach bouncing around like that? Absolutely, positively not. Lights, all kinds of different things floating around on stage. The floor is slippery. Anything could happen. So basically, this is not a matter of shaming her. This, to me, is a safety issue for the child that you are carrying. No, you should not be up on stage where something can happen to you that you could possibly cause injury to your unborn child. Has nothing to do with should a woman dance when she's pregnant or not. Because I don't know, but I know one thing for sure. When a woman is pregnant, to me, she glows. There's nothing more beautiful than seeing your woman walk around the house in her unmentionables, pregnant. Fellas, am I wrong? If you really, for those men out there, if you're being honest with yourself, that is one of probably the one most beautiful sights that a man will ever lay on. Especially if you really, really feeling that woman like you feel her, and she walk around the house like that. Come on, man. Stop it.
What the fuck, man?
Like,
what the hell is going on, man? I just, you know, I can't call it, man. Let me get through these appreciations. It says, last one, she found text with him telling his side he only marrying her because she has the money. And there you have it.
What does she expect? It's just like an older guy married a younger woman. What do you expect?
He says, Mr. DJ Music says, define short bus. Come on, bro. Like, do I have to really do that?
You know what short bus is. Hey. People for the people, students with helmets on, okay?
And that's the part that I want to talk about. You two motherfuckers. The level of depravity you have to go to use the analogy of a pregnant woman dancing on stage, calling women bitches and hoes, and try to equate that to someone's disability. And then gonna say, you know what I meant by it. Exactly. That's why I stopped. This was the purpose of me stopping, to check you two fucking niggas. This is why they make fun of our communities. This is why they make laws to protect folks with disabilities from niggas like you. This is why they have short buses. Because if you put a child on a bus with disabilities, there's going to be always stupid motherfuckers on a bus like you and Green Gorilla that's going to make fun of them. You damn right, BTS, I know what you meant. That's why I'm here. That's why I'm talking to your stupid ass. I hope that none of you two motherfuckers, I hope that none of you two motherfuckers or your supporters have a child with disabilities. And then see when that child comes home from being teased all fucking day long because he had to ride the short bus. But you call yourself a PhD. You call yourself a master teacher. They got a special place for niggas like you. They got a special place for all the supporters of yours that thought this shit was funny. That you could equate the fucked up life that you live to someone with a disability and make fun of them because they have to ride a short bus. It's motherfuckers like you that make us all look bad. Because you know what? They'll give you a pass. They'll give BGS a pass because they'll say, oh, these guys didn't mean no harm. Everybody says it. But what about the folks with families with disabilities? Did y'all ever take into account how they feel? When they see someone just blatantly make a joke thinking it's okay, oh, that nigga ride the short bus. But let me talk something about one of them ugly ass kids y'all got. Let me talk about that daughter of yours, BGS, that you threw up on the bus. The same whole culture that you talking about. Didn't somebody knock her up? Didn't somebody go raw dog up in that tramp? The short bus is for hoes. Because you got to be a damn fool to go out and give your body to anybody. Especially a motherfucker like you. If I ever see any one of you two folks, I'm looking for you. Believe me, I'm prowling the YouTube streets to catch you two motherfuckers on alive. So I can talk to you and tell you exactly what really I'm thinking. PhD, master teacher, and all your dumbass supporters. I should have flagged your channel, to be quite honest with you. I should have flagged your handle, your damn channel, for hate speech. I had every right to. Anyone that knows someone with a disability had the right to flag your channel for hate speech, for bullying. Because that's what that was, that entire stream was about. This is just the beginning, Green Gorilla. This is war. BGS, this is war. Every place I see you now, I'm there. You fired this shot. As Colonel Jessup said, you fucked with the wrong Marine. Now I got to get you. So let me let you answer that question again. You said what?
Oh, man, let me get through these appreciations. Says, last one. She found text with him telling his side he only marrying her because she has the money. And there you have it.
What does she expect? It's just like an older guy married a younger woman. What do you expect?
He says, Mr. DJ Music says, define short bus.
That's right.
Come on,
I said it. Define short bus. As you see, I came in your chat room just for that. Took me 2-3 words. That's all I wanted to know. This is why I stopped in your chat room for this and nothing else. I could have flagged you, but I didn't. I had every right to. Anyone with a disability or know someone with a disability had every right to call you out, had every right to call BGS. But I tell you what, instead of this, every place I see you two motherfuckers at, I'm going to be there and I'm going to catch you. I'm going to talk about your daughter, BGS. I don't know shit about you, Green Gorillas, so you safe. But I'm going to do my homework on you. See, the difference between me and you folks, there's no dirt behind me. So, Green Gorilla, if you ain't got no dirt, this ends now. BGS, you got dirt. So when I see you, I'm going to get up on the panel and I'm going to ask you, define short bus. Green Gorilla, when I see you on the panel, that's what I want to talk to you about. Define short bus. BGS, I'm going to light your lolly ass up. This the same nigga that told another grown man he was going to bend him over and fuck him till he liked it. I'm going to get you. I'm going to get up on the panel and I'm going to come with all the smoke. I hope you ready. I took personal offense to your stream. Now you know why.
Do I have to really do that?
You know what? Yes, you do.
Hey, hey. Students with helmets on, okay?
People with helmets on? Have your helmet on, BGS. Because I'm going to rattle your cage. Uppercuts, body blows, hooks, jabs. Every word that come out your mouth, I'm prepared for it. Promise you that. You are the master teacher, you say? Prepare to get taught when I catch you.
I'm not even trying to be deprecating to them. All I'm trying to, it's a slick name to say, we're looking at shorts.
Shorts, yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
And it's silly and like, get on the bus to go look at some shorts.
Yeah.
No, that's not what you meant. The only reason, Green Gorilla, you tried to use that, because I question you. You didn't expect anyone to question what you meant by short butts. Yes, you did. Yes, you did mean that in a derogatory term. Hopefully, to you, no one caught it. Wrong answer. I did. A motherfucker with a voice. I'm bigger than you two. Do your homework. I'm bigger than you two.
Okay. Don't read more than into it than what it is, man. You understand? Shout out to Mr. Heat again.
No, I don't understand. And I did read more into it. So with that, folks, Green Gorilla, BGS, you have been warned. Now let's move on to this next dude. I told you I had three dudes in mind. The angry man is the next guy. This guy right here, angry man, will tell you that he don't want you to give him no dollar because his content is much worth than a dollar. Don't come into his chat room and insult him with giving you a dollar or $2. This nigga, just the other night, sat for 38 minutes and berated his supporters about the lack of their support. He did everything that a typical narcissist would do. Almost had trouble getting all of that out. He did exactly what they call shame, blame, then explain. And then you niggas came up with the money. If you don't believe me, look at this shit for yourself.
Who am I supposed to make an argument that the women of today are out of pocket, that the women of today are raising frivolous concern, when I can literally see with my own two eyes that the men of today refuse to be providers? They flat out refuse.
Wait a minute. Ain't that what the women saying, angry man? This is what you say that men are doing and women are making this up, that this has not happened, but you can now, because these same men is not dropping you super chats and cash apps, you can agree with the women. Is that what you're saying, angry man?
If you go and look in the 48 laws of power, one of the laws is despise the free lunch, which basically breaks down that nothing worth any value will ever be free, is worth working for. Anything that has any value is worth paying for.
Well, did that make sense to you folks? Hold on. Let me change. Let me put on some different background music here just for a second. Hold on just a second. Let me turn it down in the back just a little bit. Let me put on some back more different background music. Now, did that make sense just now, folks? First of all, the best things in life are free. That's a proven fact. Because not everything that you spend your money on is going to be the best, right thing for you. Am I correct? The best things in life are free, like a genuine affection for someone. You can't pay for that. When you wake up in the morning and the windows open and a fresh breath of air comes in, the best things in life are free, because you know why? You just woke up. Good, bad, or indifferent. You have another chance to either do good, do bad, or change one or the other. You can't buy that in any store. So the best things in life are free. Now, you go to a store or you go to a car lot, you buy a car. 2 weeks later, the best thing you thought you could do with your money was buy that car, but 2 weeks later, the car broke down. I don't understand that logic that you just said. Maybe I'm missing something. So let me see exactly what you said. Hold on.
Use to be providers.
Okay.
They flat out refuse.
Okay.
If you go and look in the 48 laws of power, one of the laws is...
Okay, that 48 laws of power shit, we all know now that that is a farce. We all know now, if you a man that subscribes to the 48 laws of power, you a sucker. Do I need to call Prince Sunder the Queen Maker back over here to explain that shit to you, angry man?
Despise the free lunch, which basically breaks down that nothing worth any value will ever be free.
Nothing of any value will ever be free. Those two things don't go together. If it has value, that means it can't be free. Am I right? If you're trying to buy something, someone put a monetary value on something. You cannot put a monetary value on how someone feels about you. You can't pay somebody You can pay somebody to pretend that they like you, but you can't put a monetary value on a friendship. You can't put a monetary value on a marriage. You can't put monetary value on how you feel about your children. And that damn sure has value. So describe, which part of value are you talking about? Something that you go to the store, that someone placed some value on, or something that naturally has value? The fuck are you talking about?
It's worth working for. Anything that has any value is worth paying for. The reason why...
So, basically, what you're saying is, to some men, pussy has value, so it's worth paying for, right? So what you're saying is, getting rid of your ops has value, so it's worth paying for. Keeping a secret from your wife has value, so it's worth, like Donald Trump, to pay for it, to keep it a secret. That does has value. So again, who, angry man, establishes value? But this guy, I'll tell you, the reason why he's mad at you folks right now is because y'all don't pay for the game, that y'all don't pay you for the realness. Y'all don't pay you for the him for the education. The stuff that he talks about, it has so much value to it, and he feels undervalued. So he decided, before he gave y'all, his supporters, any information, he sit for 38 minutes and berate y'all and tell you you ain't shit. That this is what women think about you so far. This is the shame part that he's doing right now. Let's continue.
Why, if I'm doing this show and people aren't contributing, I'll stop talking, is because you get what you pay for. These are concepts that I completely and fully understand as a man. As a traditional man, I understand how you are supposed to operate. Spectacular. I'm still going to tip. When I leave the restaurant and the valet driver runs to go get my car, if one valet driver pulls up the car, I'm going to tip him. If another valet driver opens my wife's door, I'm going to tip both of them. But see, you bum ass niggas, just always looking for some shit for free. This is the reason people don't respect you. You go to a restaurant, you tip poorly. The next time you go to the restaurant, you get the same server. He's not excited about giving you service because he knows you're going to give him a bullshit tip. And unfortunately for us as black people, many times we go to restaurants, we don't get the best service because there is a stereotype that has some truth to it, that black people don't like to tip. So when you go to a restaurant and you see people jumping and running and hustling to go get the car of a white guy, you see the waiters running and hustling to bring the food out to a white couple, you think it's racism. It ain't racism.
You know, it's statements like that. It's diatribes like that that make me think it's not so much the person that's saying it, it's the people that's agreeing with it. This is not about so much the angry man as it is about your supporters, those people that supporting you. This is who I'm really speaking to. You are out of your fucking mind if you give this nigga any more of your money. He just said, you're not a man. Women dislike you. He just said, he just attacked your culture. He just said, this is what black people do on a general basis. Looking like a whole Cuban or Latino, feeling comfortable with his shirts called Beano Nation across his chest, as he calls it, black in name only, attacking you as a black man, as a black woman, asking you for your money. Let that make sense. Let it make sense. Try it. Because it don't. All in the name of, this is what I want to talk about tonight. And since you folks don't want to pay me, let me tell you something, Angry Man. You say the old adage goes, you get what you pay for? You damn skippy. If I know if I can go to the matinee and pay a dollar, why not wait till 3 o'clock? Because basically, all you do is a recap of celebrity gossip. I'm going to prove that. Beano Nation is not your intellectual property. I'm going to prove that. Hopefully, your supporters in this little stream that I'm uploaded will see through that bullshit and leave your channel. Now, again, if you want to take this into a fight of, because I know what you're going to say, I got more subscribers than you. He hating on me because of subscribers. He jealous, he envious of me. YouTube ate my bag, bro. This is a hobby for me. So the mere fact that I have a little over 1,100 subs, that's cool for me. I'm digging that. I'm loving it. I'm enjoying the fact that 1,100 people decided to say, hey, this guy's content, his music or whatever is good enough for me to click on and say, I subscribe to you. Don't ask him for a dime. Never sat down in a 38-minute diatribe of telling my supporters, in this case, my male supporters, that how fucked up they are because they don't give me their money. And try to make you feel bad about it, folks. And some of y'all gonna feel bad about it. Some of y'all, after he done blew you up out the water, some of y'all gonna turn around and give this nigga your money. And apologize that you couldn't give more. What kind of shit is that? What kind of racket is this? Can I try it? Wait a minute, let me do something here. Hold on. For all of y'all that wanna give up some money, yeah, look right there. You see that right there? Cash App, DJ Music. Send me some. If you want to just drop money on the floor like that, I guarantee you, I'll do a lot more with your dollars than he will do with your $20. And I'm going to show you what, that shit that he wear, that so-called drip, it ain't that easy. You fuck with the wrong dude. Let's go.
It is a cultural thing that people believe that white people will tip more than a black person tips. And why is that? Because you Negroes are always looking for something for free. Unless you're the one that's being compensated. When you have to pay the money, you want to pay as little as possible. But when you're getting paid, you want the most amount of money you can get. You know, there's some dudes that'll say, Well, angry man, you got money. That's why you do all that. And your ass is broke. But that ain't why you don't do it.
So, angry man, it's okay to beg a broke man for his money. It's okay to take the last $2 of a man. That's okay. For the sake of sitting up on a live, smoking a cigar. It's okay to charge people that you know that are broke. How much sense does that make? None. Zero. Zilch.
You don't do it because you want something for nothing. And that's why you always get nothing. You want something for nothing, and that's why you always get nothing. Do you realize that when I get ready to go somewhere, I get ready to get on a plane and go somewhere, I don't have to wait in line. I don't have to take my shoes off and do all that old extra shit that everybody else got to do. And the reason why is because I'm willing to pay the cost to be the boss.
Now, again, ladies and gentlemen, if you believe that you can go right now to the TSA, and because you decide that you want to drop the TSA agent some money, that you're not going to, you are not going to have to pay these folks some money. That's what he just tried to tell y'all just now. You're not going to have to go through the security checks because you pay some money. You're not going to have to pull your shoes off. You're not going to have to, in some cases, get your luggage checked because you paid some money to the TSA agent or the security screening agent. It pays the cost to be the boss. Are you fucking kidding me? And y'all, no one down in that chat room challenged that. I looked. I waited to see if anyone would challenge that statement. None of you did. So, angry man, go to any airport in the United States of America. Try not to show your ID. Because as of, I think of, I'm not sure when the new rule goes into effect, but no one without an ID will be able, a driver's license, a legal passport, will be able to fly on any airline in the United States. If you lost your ID, too bad. Go back, get your ID, and get you another flight. But you're not going to go through that TSA, that security checkpoint, without proper identification. No one. And that includes you, angry man. That is fact. You're entitled to your opinion, but you're not entitled to your own set of facts.
You Negroes want to be the boss, but you don't want to pay the cost. Like how you make your little comments in the chat room about, well, why should I have to do this and why should I have to do that? And I'm looking at you like, why don't you shut the hell up? You haven't paid any cost to talk any shit. Why do you think when you see a bum walking down the street yelling a bunch of obscenities and going crazy, people just drive past him? They just drive past him. Nobody stops and says, hey, buddy, what's wrong with you? Why are you so upset? No one gives a shit. No one gives a shit. But when Jay-Z stands up on the stage at the Grammys and starts talking shit, everybody was listening. everybody was listening. The problem with you men today is you want the status of somebody like a Jay-Z. You want to be treated like you're important, but you ain't did shit to be important.
My sentiment, exactly, Angry Man. You want to be treated important, like you're someone important, but that's what a narcissist thinks, that he is important. You think that when these so-called people that you have that in your chat room, when they sit down and take their time through their day and listen to you, you think the whole world has stopped to listen to you. No. You remember, since you like movies, remember Men in Black at the end of the movie after they had vanquished the bad guy and all that, and then they was going through a locker room, and then when they opened up, they was going through a room and they opened up and it was just a bunch of damn doors. This is what your YouTube stream represents. That particular thing in the Men in Black. To where there's millions and millions and millions and millions of folks that come on YouTube every day. And I'm sure that they don't look for the Angry Man's channel when they come on. Most of us find your channel through association, because I find your channel from Sotomayor. Remember Boss Talk Radio? The same shit that you was talking in 2017, 7 years later, you still talking in 2024. 7 years of bad luck. You must have broke a mirror, nigga. Because all you graduated to in 7 years is finding different ways of looking stupid. Meaning your thumbnails, your shorts, and your commentary. That's what you have done in the last 7 years. You must have broke a mirror. 7 years of bad luck, nigga. That's what the fuck you got. Because this ain't it. This stream was last night. I click on my YouTube and there you are. 7-8 o'clock in the morning. Is this your job, nigga? I hope not. See, I know a little bit more about you than you know about me, Angry Man. Folks whisper to me about you. I'm dangerous, because as far as the YouTube streets is concerned, I have no dirt. There's nothing to go back and find out about me to say, well, see, this is the same guy that 4 years ago was talking about he was a DJ. Turns out he ain't got no equipment. This is the guy that 5 years ago that said he was going to build a radio station. Turns out he don't have a radio station. This is the guy 5 years ago that said he don't talk about black women, but here's a stream. You can look at my progress. I got 1,100 subs, like I say, and I'm thankful and I'm grateful for every one of them. When they comment on something of mine, I comment back to them. I thank them. I don't ask them for a donation. Unlike you, BGS, Green Gorilla. Not saying that if somebody wants to support you, that's cool. Hey, do you.
You won't even do shit on the regular level to be important to the people you deal with. But you expect them to treat you like a...
Yeah, I'm sure the missus is all so proud that her husband or her living boyfriend or whatever the fuck you are, I'm sure she all so proud that you have accomplished to turn yourself into a YouTube content creator. With all the shit and the life skills that you say you have turned yourself as a grown 40-something-year-old man to a gossip columnist. I'm sure she liked that. Do you, Miss Lady? Probably not.
Fucking king. You expect the women you deal with to treat you like a fucking king, and you don't even want to fucking take them out to a hot meal. Why the fuck would you expect a woman to go above and beyond for your ass, and you don't even want to feed her ass? You don't even want to take her to Applebee's and get her a 2 for $20. But she's supposed to be ride or die for you?
This nigga ain't mentioned a 4-star restaurant yet. He talk about Applebee's. This is the kind of motherfucker. See, you let them talk long enough, folks, they tell you who they are. Just let them talk. Let them think they're making sense. And they tell you exactly who they are. Ladies, if you want to know if Angry Man was single, the kind of date that he would try to take you on, he just told you. 2 for Tuesdays at Applebee's. He just told you that.
With your cheap ass? Y'all complaining about hypergamy. The only reason hypergamy works so well is because anybody offering anything is better than your ass. Anybody offering anything is better than your broke bum ass. Look, Kyle Renetta said, cheap MFers. Yes. Yes.
That statement right there. What's your name? Kyron? Kyronetta? That's the statement right here that made him go harder on his male supporters. All he needed was one female to co-sign what he was saying. Ari Nicole, I don't know if you'll ever listen to this. How do you support the Angry Man? What is it about him that makes you defend this dude when he's literally talking about you as a woman? What makes you defend him? What makes you put this in this chat room, Kynetta? What makes him so likable? I want to ask you, ladies. Somebody asked me, I was on a panel, someone asked me, why don't I like Daryl Long? I must be jealous. And of course, somebody going to say that about the Angry Man. No, there's nothing that I have to be jealous about the Angry Man. Let me put on some music while I say this. There's nothing about the Angry Man that I covet. I don't covet his fans. I don't covet his talking points. I don't covet his woman. I don't covet his money. I don't covet anything about him. The only thing I ask of you as a supporter, why do you covet him? When he talks about you the way he does, there's always going to be someone that points out snake oil salesmen. There's always going to be someone that points out injustice, liars, frauds, flim-flammers. There's always going to be someone. Am I right or wrong? And I just happen to be the guy, not only me, but I'm not the only one that points out Angry Man. So my question to you is, Ari Nicole, why do y'all like him so much? Hearing how he talks about black women, hearing how he talks about men that don't support him, why do y'all even come to his channel? You can get abused anywhere and don't have to be shamed about not supporting someone because you listening to them. I didn't got to give you no money. Shit, TV is free. YouTube is free. It says I can click on anything I want to and got to pay for to listen. If you want me to pay for your content, take it over to Rumble. One person you won't find over there is me.
And I know they cheat with the women they deal with because they cheat when they come over here.
More of the shame game, fellas.
See what he's doing? Grown-ass men that will come over here, watch my show, and send me a dollar in the Cash App. Nigga, do I look like a school kid? The fuck I'm gonna do with that dollar? Go get some lollipops? The hell is wrong with you? I never went to nobody's channel and gave them a dollar. And I'm a traditional man. I understand every concept about manhood. And you know one concept that you don't understand? Giving me a dollar is insulting.
No. No. Sitting up in a chat room, smoking a cigar, telling me that I'm wrong. For offering you a dollar is insulting. That's what's insulting. Because I didn't have to give you my dollar. I don't have to click on to your stream. So it's insulting to your supporters, to the folks, whether they subscribe, whether they support, whether they drop a dollar. It's insulting to anyone that sat down and took the time to listen to your stream. That's insulting. Be happy for that dollar. I don't care. You're going to tell us in a minute. Oh, I only, listen, here.
You're at a restaurant and you have poor service, you put a dollar on the table. That's to insult the waiter. That's to let them know that their service wasn't shit.
Exactly. When I give you a dollar, that's just to let you know your content ain't worth shit. It ain't worth $2. It ain't worth this last $2. But out of respect, because I came here, even though your content is trash, I wish I had that Big J. I should have got it. But Angry Man, your content is trash. It really is. All you do is talk about other people. You're a small-minded individual. You really are. You're a small-minded man. Small-minded men, small-minded people do not talk about ideas. All they do is talk about other people. They don't talk about solutions. Small-minded people. All they talk about is other people. They never come with a solution. They always talk about it. You're a small-minded man. And you always will be. That is to your detriment because you will never break out of that box of being small-minded. Because being small-minded allows you to sit in a stream for 38 minutes and berate the people that even took the time to come to your channel and give you a dollar. They're telling you your content is trash. Just like you told that waiter their service was trash.
Silky said dollars add up.
But wait. You would think he would say, yeah, they do, Silky, and I appreciate every dollar that folks drop here. Oh, no. Listen to what he says, folks.
Okay. So, Silky, why don't you go work your job for $1 an hour? Silky. You gonna take a job for $1 an hour? Like right now, 37 people contributed. If all 37 people gave me $1, I'd have $37. That adds up. You sound like a woman right now. You sound like the type of chick that if a dude didn't have a job, she'd say, any job would do. Go get a job at Burger King. That's what you sound like.
So my question, all the women supporters down there, all the male supporters down in Angry Man's chat room, why are you still there? He just managed to completely disrespect the women in the chat room and the men in the chat room. 38 minutes, right? You got 30, you got dollar. That's how many folks you know make $37 an hour? Angry Man. How many men you know, Angry Man, since they all down in the chat room that's broke? Do any of them men down in that chat room make $37 an hour? Because that's what you made, according to you. You haven't been there 30 minutes, 38 minutes. So if you look at it in its smallest way, as I do, you made $37 in less than an hour. That is well over the national average. I think the national average is $15 now. Just, yeah, what, $17 over the pay scale? But just sitting in a room talking about other people. Not a bad gig for a small-minded person. That's if you can get the gig.
That's what you sound like. I prefer quality over quantity. That's another issue that you dudes have. You prefer quantity over quality. That's why you out here smashing 20, 30 trifling chicks instead of getting one good woman. You don't understand quality over quantity.
Ooh, I do. Mister, can I answer that? I understand quality over quantity. I know one thing for sure, Angry Man. I'm not going to buy a bunch of bullshit because it's cheap. I'm going to buy something that's going to last. I'm going to make sure that when I spend my money, it's worth the money that I'm spending. If I come into your chat room and decide to drop a dollar, that should tell you everything. Just like that waiter. All right, I'll tip you a dollar, man. I like you enough to come through and listen to your shit. Here go a dollar, bro. All right, I know I'm coming back again. I'll give you a dollar. Here you go. These dollars, last $2. What a maroon.
No, you made your point, sir. No, I didn't make my point. Let me take one more jab at it. Don't ask for the smoke and then get mad when it gets smoky. Let me take one more jab at it. Let me ask you this question, since you want me to stop talking. Let me ask you this question, Silky. Have you donated to the channel? Have you contributed to the channel? other than your bullshit ass opinion? Have you contributed to the channel? Tell you what you're gonna fuck around and do. You dudes gonna keep coming in here pissing me off, and what's gonna end up happening is I'ma do a fucking pivot you gonna hate. I'ma do a pivot out of this damn world. You keep coming in here fucking with me, getting on my nerves, and I'ma start going in on you niggas every day. And you know what the difference will be? The difference, as opposed to me going in on the chicks every day, is if I sat up here and went in on you niggas every damn day, I'd make a ridiculous amount of money. You know why? Because the women are coming here and pay to see you niggas get roasted. With your broke asses. I come from the era where if you ain't kicked out no money, keep your motherfucking mouth shut. You ain't kicked out no bread, shut up.
I wanted that to be uninterrupted. One word, two words, the audacity of this nigga. The audacity of this angry man. This poor excuse of a content creator. This potbelly, three sandwich, no content having motherfucker. With the waist trainer shirt on. Talking about other folks and what they ain't donating to his channel. And y'all about to wait.
Every time I go to somebody's channel, when I talk my shit in the chat room, how do I do it, y'all? When I talk my shit in somebody's chat room, how do I do it?
Nigga, what's that say? If you got to pay to be seen, what's that telling you, angry man? If you got to drop a 20 ball or a 100 ball, and basically you're trying to get up on a panel, you're just paying to be seen. Don't brag. Don't brag on it. Because, you know, when I'm typing in the chat room, folks always repeating what I'm saying. Remember, I just typed that down a little bit in the Green's Gorilla's chat. Got his attention, though, didn't it? And didn't have to spend 20 on it. Got his attention, didn't it? So basically, you a pay-to-play loose nigga. Y'all wonder where I coined the term and why? Because this is why. You will sell your ass. You will sell your soul. You will sell anything to get in front of a motherfucker so you can drop your opinion. Loose niggas. To the highest bidder. Y'all will sit on panels with men that talking about, I will marry a 14-year-old. Y'all will go from panel to panel and let this motherfucker explain. I'm talking about Fatty. Explain to the world why it's okay, because he says it's legal somewhere in some part of the world, that y'all sit around as United States citizens and allow this shit to go on. Then super chat him. You hear another motherfucker talking about, I seen his babies naked, but yet Jay Prince just 2 weeks ago, I saw you in the chat room sitting there buddy-buddy with this motherfucker. Now, because it's profitable, what y'all do? What y'all do now? Let's call the truce, man. We can make us some money.
You see angry man on somebody else's show in the chat room, how do I talk my shit?
talk my shit in a super chat. And guess what? The bigger the shit I'm talking, the more amount I spend. So if I go in there and I say something light, $10 super chat. If I crack a joke, $20 super chat. If I want to talk big shit, $100 super chat. So I'm not sitting here talking about some shit I don't do myself. And don't be sitting there, look, check this out. Don't be sitting there getting upset because I'm talking shit. Y'all open this can of worms. I was minding my damn business. Y'all came in here spewing out that BS and opened that can of worms. And you should know by now. If you don't know, you better ask somebody. I've been doing this shit since 2017. Anybody that came in here talking about some, well, why should I donate? I eviscerated their ass. I make a whole stream about the shit.
My point exactly. 7 years, 17, 2017, 2024, 7 years you've been doing this and y'all still supporting the angry man. You heard it out his own mouth. I've been eviscerating niggas who don't support my channel for 7 years and y'all still come over here.
And ain't nothing that comes out of my mouth, you're not gonna be able to dispute any of it. Logically, you ain't gonna be able to dispute any of it because you're wrong off the rip.
Well, actually, I'm your Huckleberry. I think I'm doing a pretty good job of disputing your logic.
When y'all think so? If you don't want to contribute, just don't. But don't be trying to make no damn case for why nobody should, because you don't have a case.
No, 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 angry man. No one has ever made a case for someone donate to your channel. You're making the case that someone should not donate a dollar to your channel. That's an insult to you. So either give me more than a dollar or don't donate. That's exactly what you're saying. There's no one painting that narrative but you. Not your fans, not your supporters, not anyone who listened to you. You the nigga that has created that narrative. You and you alone. The fuck are you talking about? Nigga, please.
Tell you right now, the state of masculinity is sad and pathetic. The state of masculinity today is sad and
What does your masculine behavior have anything to do with donating to Angry Man's channel? First, he attacked you with women. Then he attacked your wallet. Now he's attacking your manhood. He also attacked your intelligence, but y'all still gonna donate to him and then explain why you did. We got the shame and the blame from Angry Man, and you niggas in a little while gonna explain to Angry Man why you ain't been giving him your money.
Pathetic. It's pitiful. And the funniest thing about it is you can sit here and make all of these excuses about how the women of today ain't this and the women ain't that and the women doing this and the women doing that. But I tell you some real shit. It don't even matter if it's good women out here, because when they encounter y'all bum asses, they ain't gonna be able to find a decent man any damn way.
Notice he'll take his time and not say nothing for a little while. Look at the look on his face, folks, like a pouting child. I didn't get what I want for Christmas, so I'm going to talk shit until I do, until I get my way. Look at him. Look at his face. He's pouting like a little bitch. Like
well, a bitch ass nigga. Shout out to Naughty Germ. He said, I wish I could support more. Appreciate you, fam. Shout out to Avery. He said, hope this is not insulting. I donated $1 before. Hey, man, I appreciate you, bro. Shout out to OG Sigma. He said, talk your shit, fam. Shout out to Big Mike in the building. Big Mike said, paying dues, hit the cash app. Appreciate you, bro.
All right, listen, I'm the Team Skull boss, and I ain't ever been scared of nothing or nobody. Heck, I live my life scared of nothing or nobody. Heck, I live my life making people scared of me. So listen to what Big Bad Guzma has to say. Y'all are stupid!
Yep. Y'all are stupid. Did you hear what motherfucker said? Hey, angry man, I'm sorry. I donated $1, but let me give you more. Appreciate you calling, checking me, man. My bad. All these motherfucking grown-ass men explaining to another nigga who sat here for 38 minutes and called you everything except a child of God. That made you feel so bad as a man. You decided to pull out your credit card and cash app this nigga some money. And wonder why these women talk shit about y'all. Wonder why these women call y'all niggas dick riders. They have every right to, because we just heard five niggas. Let me back up a little bit. Call them out again for me, angry man.
Avery said, hope this is not insulting. I donated $1 before. Hey man, I appreciate you, bro. Shout out to OG Sigma. He said, talk your shit, fam. Shout out to Big Mike in the building. Big Mike said, paying dues, hit the cash. I appreciate you, bro.
Big Mike must have dropped some coins, because that nigga got excited on that one. Big Mike in the building. This nigga just sat here and talked shit about y'all, and you gave him your money because he made you feel bad? Really? Nothing this nigga said in the last 30 some minutes will ever make me donate to his channel. Nothing. I'm gonna prove it. He says he has valuable content that y'all should pay for. I'm gonna prove to you that he doesn't. All this guy is a cheap imitation of a gossip columnist. That's exactly what he is. Nothing more, nothing less. Watch.
All right, listen, I'm the Team Skull boss, and I ain't ever been scared of nothing or nobody. Heck, I live my life scared of nothing or nobody. Heck, I live my life making people scared of me. So listen to what Big Bad Guzma has to say. Y'all are stupid!
Come over here with that goofiness. Ain't nobody trying to hear that goofiness. If you suffer from my funds alone, go get that shit fixed. Don't come over here with it. Shout out to Lifeline Music. I've said it numerous times. My show is not Walmart. My show is not Dollar General. My show is not a convenience store. My show is Louis Vuitton. My show is Saks Fifth Avenue. My show is Gucci. My show is a boutique. It's not no fucking convenience store. This ain't the place where you stand outside of there, of the store with a brown paper bag drinking your damn liquor.
Okay, folks. Angry Man says he has great content, right? All right, let's take a look. There's the Angry Man channel in front of you. Let's move around a little bit. All right. The Angry Man. Right. What's this right here? Gossip. He's talking about Cam Newton. Gossip. He's talking about Fonnie Willis. Oh, let's check out a short that he's going to do. This is gonna give you some information.
You know what's irritating me about this whole situation with the series Who the F Did I Marry? Is that people keep asking questions about, well, why did she put up with this? Why did she stay so long? He was paying the bills. She was not used to that. And then, sprinkle, sprinkle. This is part of the sprinkle, sprinkle lifestyle that women don't talk about. Because Cher doesn't talk about finding a man with good moral standards.
Do I need to say more? So this is what he has berating you folks, saying that he has content. His content is great. You folks need to, he's not Walmart. He is Gucci. He is not the outlet store. He is a boutique. Yeah. That's what I say, too. Nigga, please. Yeah. There's some great content. Look, there's more. What are you doing? What are you talking about here? Who are we talking about here? Look. What content, folks? What is he talking about? Nothing. More gossip. He's talking about the why did I get married lady. Okay, let's go a little bit more. Great content, angry man. Yeah, right, nigga. Oh, here we go. Let's see. He posted something. Let's see. What are you talking about? There he is, talking about Charleston White. Got Charleston White in the picture, trying to draw some attention to him. Okay? Nothing. Okay? 33 comments about nothing. Okay? Let's move on. What else he doing? Nothing. Anything of value here, folks? Anything you see of value so far on Angry Man's channel? There he is, talking about the why did I get married? Part two. Uh-oh, talking about Benzino. Wait, what else are you doing? Oh, let me move back up. Let me go back up. Great content, Angry Man. Yeah, you're really putting out some hard-hitting info that's going to really help the black community. Oop, let's go to your channel. What's over here? Nothing. The Angry Man standards. Uh-oh.
The realest show on YouTube. We are back in the building yet again. Yep.
Nothing.
We had a great show yesterday. We talked about
there's this content, folks. Cat Williams. He talking about Ari Spears, another Cat Williams, and Ricky Smiley. There he is talking about the why did I get married lady again. There he is. More bullshit. He's talking about somebody else now. There more. No original content. He's reaction to somebody else. There he is. Talking about Fonnie Willis. There he is. Talking about Benzino. There he is. Talking about Dr. Umar. What content is Angry Man developing? There he goes again, talking about Dave Chappelle and Cat Williams. There he is again, talking about Fonnie Willis and you black women again and how shit y'all ain't. There he goes. This is what the Angry Man is doing on this channel. That's talking about he is not a boutique, folks. Look, nothing but gossip on this channel. Nothing. Nothing but gossip. That's what he is. He's not a content creator. He is a bona fide gossip columnist. That's exactly what he is. Nothing more, nothing left. Look at some of the folks that he's following. The Grinch. Who else? What the fuck? Look at the niggas that he's following. The Angry Man Life. Nobody coming to see you, Otis. The fuck is this about, man? This motherfucker right here.
Don't need to be in here. Fuck out of here with that goofy shit.
He's trying to think of some more nastygrams for you folks. How you reading the chat now? Trying to see what you folks is talking about? I told you, he's a reactionary. He has no content. Potbelly, three sandwich eating, no content having motherfucker is what you are, angry man. Bottom line. That's exactly what you are.
I need a 38 fucking vacation.
Minutes. Yeah, you need to get the fuck off YouTube. That's what you need to do.
I need a damn vacation. That's right, Kendra. Thank you. Beano Nation is a luxury brand.
Oh, is it? Is Beano Nation a luxury brand? Let's go see.
It's a luxury brand.
There it is, folks. Beano Nation. Let's see what the Beano Nation consists of. Nothing but another way for Angry Man to get you to donate to his channel. Nothing about him says I had some more information over there. So what is Beano Nation? What does it mean? What is it, Beano? We're going to find out here in a minute. Hold on to your hats, folks. I'm telling you. But you folks, I said, he says, remember now, he says he has quality content. Y'all seen any quality content yet? Could you not go to any other channel and get someone else's opinion? Let's see what some of the pictures that represent the Beano Nation. Let's look. Look for yourself, folks. Look at those pictures right here. Let's get some more. Some of them going to come up here. Hold up. Told you, I'm thorough when I see some bullshit. I got to call out bullshit. Look at that. Look at the picture. The angry man. An AI-generated picture. All he did was add some shit to. Again, another AI-generated picture that all he did was add some words to. What nigga in their right mind run around with a fur coat on in the middle of the goddamn summer? His drip. We're going to talk about that in a minute, too. Look. Got Kevin Samuels all up in this shit. Look at the angry man. Look. Look, 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 look. Look, AI generated. Nothing about this man says originality. Nothing. But he's berating y'all, talking about, I need more than a dollar. You lucky that anybody gives you a dollar for this bullshit that you are putting up here, angry man.
Desperate, destitute, plebeian people. Beano Nation is not a group of lumpen proletariats. The Beano Nation is the best of us. Beano Nation consists of blue collar workers and business owners, people that pay their way, people that pay their fair share, people that's about their business. Know what you thought it was. I'm sitting here right now, smoking expensive cigars with diamonds on. With manicured nails, dude. The average guy that's married has a regular wedding band. That's what I wear. A fucking diamond encrusted wedding band.
All right, folks. I want y'all to notice that ring right there. He says this diamond encrusted, right? Well, you know, there are things on the internet that you can take a picture of something and it will take you to the exact place where you can buy it. It'll even give you the price. Well, fortunately for me, I have such software. So I click on to the picture that he's showing right there after I froze it in that particular manner. And guess where it took me to? You'll see in a second. Walmart. $5.91. Men's fashion 18 karat gold, solid yellow gold, 2.5 cubic zirconium natural diamond. I mean, not cubic zirconium, CT natural diamond wedding band rings for $5.91. That is the same exact ring that he just showed you, folks. That's the same exact ring that he showed you. He must have went on a shopping spree to Walmart one day. Maybe when he got that stimulus check or when he got that last YouTube check. Can't make this shit up, folks. You cannot make this up. This nigga right here. You can't make this up. Look for yourself. Am I lying, folks? Is that not the same ring that he just showed you? I think so. Add to the cart, angry man. You want that? Damn, nigga. There it is, folks. That's the same ring. So you know I didn't make it up. You know I didn't make it up. Okay?
A fucking diamond encrusted wedding band. It costs more than your car. Don't come in here with that goofy shit with me.
All right. So he gonna lean back, and folks, you notice he gonna tell you about the new shirt that he got on, the Beano shirts. But also, you notice that lavish looking silver chain that he got around his neck? Guess what?
Shout out to R. Jizzle. And they up there arguing and got people up there that's annoying, and watch how much bread get dropped. Stop telling me dudes ain't got it. You're lying. You're lying.
Damn. He paid more for than the chain that he paid for the wedding band, folks. Wait, I'm not lying. Folks, this is the same exact chain. It says B-style 12 millimeter Miami Cuban chain necklace, stainless steel, chunky choker necklace, cool swag, heavy curb neck chain for men or for women, 18 inch. Is that not the same chain that this nigga is wearing around his neck for $36 at Walmart? Is that not the same fucking chain, angry man? Let's go into more detail. I'm almost done here, folks. We ain't got much longer. Let's continue some more.
There we go.
See, there goes the chain. See, there goes the chain right there, folks. It's the same chain from Walmart for $36 plus shipping and handling.
And it's another channel I watch, and they be having the bounties. There's people to get on my nerves, and I be wanting to kick them off the camera so I can save my money for that. I respect you more if you said that. And to come in here hemming and hawing, talking about, well, why would we have to, and why would we, and why, man, shut up. Sponsor of the show, my man, Carell. Salute to everybody else that came and contributed. You know, I appreciate you guys. Salute to the whole Beano Nation. If you have not grabbed your copy, I think I got my copy here somewhere. If you have not grabbed your copy of The Angry Man Standard, all you have to do is go to Amazon, type The Angry Man Standard in the search bar, and it will come up.
Now, you know, of course, I was going to do that, Angry Man. It says The Angry Man Standard, a traditional relationship solution for the modern man. After he sat here for 30 some odd minutes berating you niggas, now he gonna tell you to go buy his book for $44 more. Actually, I think he's got 12 ratings. Let's see. Let's see if anybody else, what they say about the book. What they say. What they say about it. Angry Man. Y'all can go and read the little preface that he has down there. I'm not going to read that bullshit. Not me. Hell no. This motherfucker right here got y'all buying the Angry Man standards. Came out November. So far, folks, I've checked the book sale count. I think he sold about 20 copies of this book. I can guarantee you, this motherfucker is not going to reach the bestseller list. You can bet that. What's that say right there? Hold on, let me see what it says. Somebody gave him some props. Let me see if I can read it. Hold on just a second. That's what it said. The book had me engaged from the very first sentence. Really? What about the book had you so engaged? I would like to know. But you're entitled to your opinion. You like it. I love it. And so, sound like a pseudo name to me. Angry Man, to be quite honest with you, if I read this paragraph out, it would sound like you. It would sound like something you would say. If I read that out aloud, I think you went and put the only, other than Soul Shader, and that's one of your partners, that's the only ones that gave you anything favorable about this particular book here. Anything favorable. Nothing about the Angry Man stats says, go out and buy this book right away. Absolutely nothing. Nothing about this book says, go buy this book right away. Nothing. Look for yourself, folks. Nothing about this say, go buy me. Look, even that crown right there on the book, that is something borrowed. You can go and click on that and go find several copies of what that crown is for.
We go to the description at the bottom, and I have a link in the description. Also, just so I can show you, if you like the shirt that I have on today, if you scroll down, you'll notice that they are down here at the bottom. You can grab your Beano Nation shirt. You feel me? You can grab your Beano Nation shirt over at the Beano Bistro. You feel me? So grab your shirt today. You want to rep Beano Nation? We also...
Beano, folks, you're going to have a hard time explaining to this perfume company why you got try to use the name Beano Bistro, Angry Man. You're going to have a hard time asking them, telling these people, why are you calling yourself Beano Nation? This is trademarked right here. Beano is trademarked, and it does not mean black in name only. Beano has a significance to it. Continue. You folks that's saluting the Angry Man, or you can maybe go and get you some Beano harnesses. How about that? Or maybe, let's see right here, you can figure out what Beano really means, and it's not black in name only. Short, Childish Gambino. That's when this came into popularity. Okay, but it has another meaning. Let's continue. Beano. Okay, which part of this? You folks, not unless you're from this particular area. Beano, a long-haired beast from Buffalo. The personality of going to the gym, lifting a few times, and becoming hard fast. Beano. Or maybe it's one of these other definitions of Beano Nation that he's trying to get you folks to sign up to. I don't know. Let's see. Beano. Big Black. Wait a minute. What's it say right there? Beano. Big Black. Beautiful. Buffalo. Beano. That's right. We said it. Black. Beano is black. But he tells you, Beano Nation is black in name only. Let it make sense, folks. This is the guy that you're supporting. Oh, Beano. Where's the originator of Beano from? Originally came from, I think it says Italian. Yep. Beano, small child. As in Bambino. But he's trying to tell you folks that you are pay your money to become part of the Beano Nation. How to pronounce Beano. Make sure we got it right. Okay? Let's go.
Beano.
Beano.
Okay. So we know we're pronouncing it correctly. He says Beano Nation. So Angry Man, which part, wait a minute, of the Italian influence should these folks be paying you to become a part of? Which part of the Beano Nation should you be telling these folks that they're, since they're from Italy, there's no person from Italy will say, I'm black in name only. You might want to drop that Beano. Folks, you might want to stop supporting this fucking clown. You might want to stop spending your hard-earned money supporting this dumbass. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I got nothing else to say. Watch your 3, your 6, and your 9. I'm about you. Have a good night. Have a good day. Be safe.